Right. So do you think that Leche can be redeemed for all that she's done to the sisters?
Good question. Be redeemed.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a deep vulnerability to Rachel that we've seen kind of over the seasons, and as much as she sort of goes about things in a very misguided way, in a very kind of like cruel way, she does, her intention is, like all of the clones, to just have some control over her life, and some autonomy, and some kind of volition in it. So maybe, I mean, if we experience something of a, if she gives up some power, if there's some
truce of some sort,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
she kind of gets what she wants.
Wow. I think if she reconciles too that she's a clone,
yeah,
she's
yeah,
like the rest of them, yeah, that she's not different. Yeah.
All right, so you two just now made me come up with a question about, do you do this, talking about character choices and stuff together?
Yeah,
a lot.
Yeah. I think
discuss.
Well, Tatiana's been incredibly open to that throughout the process of every season of the show, and I think that's something incredibly unique, and that's something that I didn't expect from the actor that I was going to be working with before I knew Tat, and that I could see that it would be understandable for an actor to not be open to the opinions of someone else who needs to play their characters. So it's incredibly unique, but Tat's been so generous and open to discussion, and it's never right or wrong, and things can be thrown out, or things can be valuable and used, but it's just kind of discussion just helps the art grow a little bit more.
Totally. Just having a collaborator in character creation is kind of unique, and getting, you know, and Kathryn comes to set having watched all the dailies and having seen the arc of the characters in a way that I don't see because I'm kind of there in it, and she has questions about the scenes, or she has questions about the characters, or thoughts, or ideas that are stimulating to me and make me see things differently, and we improvise within takes too, you know, and those, that improv becomes part of the scene then, you know, when we flip the characters to the other side. So it's a real collaboration. Yeah.
How was it this past season as far as like working through the desperation of like running out of hope as far as finding a cure and things like that?
It's you know, it's tough because you've fallen in love with these characters and they seem fragile at this point. You know, Cosima's health seems really, I think when we left her at the end of episode 10, it was kind of like she could be gone. So it's interesting to play in those places and sort of, you know, I don't want the characters to die, but if the story does, you know, then they could. So it's a kind of painful, but you know, but it is fun to work through those things. Yeah.
So Allison was kind of separated from like the rest of the sisters this season, and she's trying to live a normal life. Are we going to see more of her working with the other sisters in season 5?
Yeah, I think so. She's kind of in the woods with Helena, so they have like unexpected, like, again, they're forced into, like, confinement with each other. But now it's Helena's rules. Helena's home. It's different. I would love to see those two do a little bit more together. Because
yeah,
it's such an unlikely pairing.
Yeah. That'd be great.
Hopefully.
But Allison was saying, didn't she say, like, toward the end of the season when they were in the tent, how much she appreciated her? I mean, was she being sarcastic or was she being serious about?
Oh, I think she was totally serious. I think she went through a huge crisis of faith last season where God had abandoned her. And then suddenly in her moment just before, you know, death or whatever was going to happen with that bot, an arrow through the throat and it's Helena, you know, at the door. So I think she definitely saw that as an angel from Jesus, God.
We have time for one more here.
How do y'all typically feed off each other when y'all are working together in scenes?
Tatiana's incredibly easy to feed off of because your energy is just, she just gives it her all every single take she's there. And it doesn't matter if you're in like minus 30 degree weather or if it's hour 22, like she's a pro. She's always there. So my job is to just try to match that and to give her as much as I can give her to make her be the best that she can be, because ultimately she's the only one that's seen. So it's super cool. You just like I've never worked with an actor of just your skill and energy.
Sugar rush?
But you pull it off, whatever you do. So, yeah, it's great.
So will your next role be supporting role, or do you have to do a lot of stuff, or are you just going to try to take it easy for
them? I don't know. It depends. Whatever comes up. I'd love to play like a small bit thing in a movie or something. A really, you know, strong character of some kind. That's kind of what I like to do. But whatever happens, I'm up for it.